Hey drivers, YouTube's DOT physical expert, Dr. Nuesse, back again with another video. This one on a confusing subject for a lot of drivers and even some providers, and this one's on smoking. This is about drivers who are smokers. When they come in to take their DOT physical, there are very specific parameters that the FMCSA sets up, and I want to talk about these and make it very, very clear what's going to happen if you are a smoker when you go into take your DOT physical, or if you are a provider and the driver that you are examining is a smoker. Very, very important subject here. All right, so let's talk about the standard. Here it is. This is right from the Certified Medical Examiner's Handbook that all of the providers get. And it states very, very clearly, the standard is that if a driver comes in to get their medicals done, their DOT physical done, and they are over the age of 35 and a current smoker, that they must have specialized lung function testing. So what does this actually mean? So this means even if you have no symptoms at all and you check smoking on your intake paperwork, or you say to the examiner that you are a current smoker, even if you have no symptoms at all, and even if the examiner can't find anything wrong with your lungs or your breathing, automatically if you're over 35 and a current smoker, you have to have this specialized lung function testing done. Unfortunately, a lot of places that do DOT physicals don't do this test. It's a very specialized test. You will get referred to a testing center or a hospital, and that can be costly. It can delay your certification, etc., etc. A major inconvenience, I understand, but again, this is a directive straight from the FMCSA. There's no getting around this as the provider. If you're over 35 and you currently smoke, you're going to be required to have this test done in order to meet your certification. Now, there are also parameters that you have to fall within once you take this test. It's not just take this specialized test and then you're automatically certified. You have to fall within certain parameters to then be certified. So it's another big hoop to jump through. Let's talk about that next. And first, let me just make very, very clear that we're talking about cigarette smoking. The FMCSA does not say anything about the occasional cigar smoker. You know, if you have a cigar once a month with your buddies or something like that, or if you vape even, they haven't made any distinction or any standard about vaping currently. We're talking about current cigarette smokers specifically. So if somebody comes in and they say, I smoke a cigar every once in a while, or they have a vape pen in their pocket or something like that, and I see it, that I will typically let go unless, again, I find something on the physical exam that indicates that I need to do additional testing. So cigarette smoking is what we are talking about. Okay, so if you are over 35 and a smoker, you're going to be sent for this additional testing. It's called lung function testing or spirometry. And on this exam, and you don't need to know exactly the particulars about how they're finding this out, but you're going to breathe into a tube and your FEV1, meaning how much air you can expel, needs to be 65% of what the predicted amount would be. So 65 is the magic number on this test. Now, if you fall below that, you will have to then have an additional test. It's called partial pressure of arterial oxygen, and that has to be 65 millimeters of mercury. If you fall below both of these tests, you are not going to be able to be certified, unfortunately. Now, I've only seen this in my office happen one time, where I've had to send a driver away to get this test done, and they've come back and they've given me their paperwork and they don't meet either of these two standards. I've seen it once over 7 years. So most of the time I send drivers to get this done and it's just a hoop that they have to jump through. They come back, they've met the first standard, and we can certify them after that. My advice, and I think it's obvious, is quit smoking before you go in to take your DOT physical. This is a very simple thing that you can do. The FMCSA is very, very clear on this. They don't make any distinction between if you quit 10 years ago, 2 months ago, or 2 weeks ago. It's just if you are not a current smoker at that time. So if you're a current smoker, at the time of your physical and over 35, it's going to trigger this automatic test. If you are a former smoker of any type, of any time frame, you're not automatically going to be sent for this test. Now, that does not mean that the doctor, the provider that is doing your exam is not going to want additional testing. I'm just saying that it's not going to be automatic. I hope that is very, very clear. All right, drivers, please stay subscribed to this channel. When the FMCSA makes updates, I am going to make update videos so that you stay informed. And if you want additional information, you can connect with me directly. There is information in the description box about how to do that on a one-on-one session. All right, drivers, until next time, stay safe.